No, Secretary, following the eruption of Mount Bulusan, what is the Department of Health doing on the ground?
Oh, well, a lot. You know, I have been meeting with my director, Ernie Vera of Region 5, Bicol, no? And I have instructed that all the prepositioned supplies must already be distributed to the affected families and especially those in the evacuation centers, no? And I've also already instructed the distribution of N95 masks and N88 surgical masks to protect our people from the ashfall and its impact on eyes. Kaya may advisory tayo on eye care, on respiratory care, as well as the proper handling and preparation of food and of course, boiling of water. So we have already cascaded all the advisories to the affected communities through the Region 5 DOH in coordination with the local government units. No? So nagpadala tayo, halimbawa yung pangalaga sa, well, we have already sent the hygiene kits, the potable water jerry cans or containers, and these have been already distributed, ongoing pa rin the distributions sa Tuban, no? But anyway, just to emphasize that napaka-importante that our people are protected from the impact of the ashfall. Well, that's why yung magsuot ng safety goggles and the face mask is an important reminder. Huwag mo lang gumamit ng contact lenses kung naka-contact lens, no? Kasi mamaya kakamutin yung mata dahil initan na itong fluorine and ashfall elements, no? Yung consultation natin ng mga pasyente, no, na pagka may mga symptoms. So all these advisories, I don't have to put them or enumerate them one by one. We can just send you all these advisories.
All right, Secretary.
Lungs.
Okay, Secretary, you mentioned goggles. I'm curious, did you mean the Department of Health is also distributing goggles to residents, or that's for the healthcare workers?
That's for the healthcare workers, and also what is important is for them to be given their face mask N95 and N88.
Is the Department of Health covering anything for the residents or LGU po yun?
No, it is a whole government approach here. No? So the national government complements whatever LGU lacks. We fill in the gaps. So that has been what is being done. So tuloy-tuloy at pagbibigay natin ang mga supplies and personal protective equipment or PPEs.
Now, this is not the first volcano eruption under your term. What should residents watch out for with a phreatic eruption? What's the effect on their health? Short-term, medium-term, long-term?
Well, yung immediate term, no, is to really avoid going out of their residences, no, and they should make sure that their windows are covered with wet blankets or anything that would effectively filter out the ashfall and its toxic components or elements, no. So carbon dioxide is one. Fluorine is another one, no? Which can irritate the eyes, the lungs, and other parts of the body, the skin, no? For example. So we're taking care of that eventuality, but it is best to prevent. And so we advise our residents there to avoid going out as much as possible, no? And to make sure that they apply, you know, pagpasang mga blankets or para lang magkaroon ng filtration against these toxic substances. And then the wearing of face masks, no? Both N95 and N88 are very important. And our local health care frontliners, together with the DOH, they are monitoring the health situation there. Dahil alam mo na ba, pagdating sa mga evacuation centers, yung hawaan, malakas ang possibility niya, no? Kasi halos tabi-tabi na naman ng mga tao dyan. So we continuously remind them of the health protocols that we have already put in place ever since naman, like, you know, Taal volcanic eruption, nagkaroon na tayo last year, March 2020, and also last year, and then ngayon, ganoon din, no? So pretty much our people are already sanay na, no, to respond this pandemic.
I'm curious, will the president be visiting? Will you be joining him, if ever?
Yeah, maybe. That's why we're going there. Immediately after this, I'm flying to Davao City and get our presidential directive. If he decides to go there, we all will go there. Mm-mm. Immediately, if the president's judgment calls for it.